time. So let's see, where are we? Number two went down. Number four went down. How about number five? Well, Oklahoma can't lose to Baylor. They've never lost to Baylor in the whole history of Earth. 20-0. With under 3 minutes to go in the game, tied at 10, 3 minutes to go in the first half, I should say. Robert Griffin III to Kevin Reese. Great last name, that Reese, as he goes 69 yards. How did he get so open, Lou? What could happen to Javon Harris?
Well, you know, he takes his eyes off of it. He's going to start a double move. See how he starts in, the safety comes with him, then he's going deep on it. They have great speed. Just remember this, first play of the game, Baylor had an 80-yard touchdown pass called back. They just got open with double moves, time after time.
Bob Stoops was reminding Harris, this is not just a game. It was supposed to be a big game. 24-17, Oklahoma. Oh, the deflection and Kendall Wright.
Terrific job of concentration by Kendall Wright, never giving up on the play, keeping his eyes on the football. Good things happen. He comes down with the ball 87 yards later. It's a touchdown for Baylor.
Another look at this. Oh, some night it's just bouncing your way. Griffin. Even Griffin was in a little disbelief after the 87-yard touchdown. What? Does that count? Yeah, I'll take it. Baylor ties the game at 24, under 2 minutes to go in the third. Same score, Baylor in the red zone. Jordan Nyver knifing his way into the end zone, and the Bears have the lead. Fourth quarter, OU trying to answer. Landry Jones picked off by K.J. Morton. Baylor would score to make it 38-24. 6 minutes to go. Oklahoma at the four. Here comes Blake Bell, short yardage, Mark.
Oh, terrific job of blocking up front. When they get inside the five-yard line in that area, you know if Blake Bell's in there, they're going to run the football, Baylor.
Now under a minute to go. Same score. Here he comes again.
Running the football, Baylor. You need to get 9 or 10 in the box to slow the big fella down.
Fourth touchdown rushing for Bell, the short yardage quarterback. Now, two-point conversion attempt. Baylor hadn't been able to stop it all night. Going to run it again, but the Sooners, much to Bob's chagrin, call for a false start. Now he's got to kick it and tie it, so now surely we're headed to overtime, except there's no reason to play conservatively when you have RG3.
He just did some great scrambling here, about three plays in a row, picking up in the average about 15 yards. Put him in maybe field goal range.
Look, that's all they need is a field goal. Be careful with the football. Mm-hmm. You can't just throw it into the end zone unless Terrence Williams is there for the touchdown. Baylor, Waco on fire. The biggest thing that had ever happened in Waco until tonight is they invented Dr. Pepper there way back in the day. Now everybody have a refreshing beverage. Baylor beats Oklahoma for the first time ever, and Bob Stoops' dreams are shattered.
What was going on? They were beating us. So in the end, when they spread you out the way they do, and have the ability to run the football, they stretch it. And a lot of guys have to make some one-on-one battles, and they out-executed us, and more than we were out-execute them.
Well, they were playing pretty soft, so, you know, most of your reads go out the window. You're just trying to, you know, find a seam and maybe find somebody open. And then when I looked down the field, I saw him one-on-one. All this is happening in milliseconds, so I saw him one-on-one. I was like, well, I'll give him a shot, and I threw it up, and he made a great catch.
That's the kind of guy that can make plays for you. He's not afraid to take the risk. Griffin threw for 479, four touchdowns. Doesn't run as much as he possibly could, but when he does, he's so fast, a track guy. Yeah. It was a remarkable performance.
And it was on a big stage, and he had to make a big game, and he had a big game on a big stage. And what Robert Griffin III was able to do in this game is make plays, particularly when they counted. If he wasn't sitting in the pocket getting great protection, he was reading the defense. Here comes the blitz. He's got to read the blitz. He's got to get rid of the football. Stands in the pocket, looks down the field, stands tall, throws it for the completion, and a terrific job of picking up extra yardage on the play. And not only that, when you look at this offense for Baylor, the entire offense got involved. The wide receivers got yards after catch. Here, watch Robert Griffin. It's not going to be there. He's going to step up in the pocket. Okay, make something happen. Go laterally. Look down the field of play. With a defender in his face, cool as a cucumber, throws the ball into the end zone for another score. Which was most impressive to me about Robert Griffin III in a two-minute situation. With less than a minute, they had the ball, taking it down the field of play. Two runs, 30 yards, two passes. 46 yards and the winning touchdown. In that situation, under the most pressure that you can have as a quarterback, gets the job done.
It was tremendous effort on his part. I mean, one of the great things I've seen since I've been around the game. Football is a long time, but that was a bad Oklahoma defense. I don't care how you twist it or turn it. They didn't break on the ball. Let's look at some of the things they've done here, Reese.
Yeah, they've allowed 500 yards in four games. This is a defense that was supposed to be dominant this year. They've allowed 40 or more in two games. It's the most in the season since 08, and then they've allowed 500 in two straight games.
When Oklahoma was great, they allowed 500 yards in four games, period.